In this video, we're going to use AutoCAD to help us in the analysis of beams. Here's a problem from Beer and Johnson's book. We have a cross-section of a beam which looks like a T, subjected to an applied bending moment. To find out the bending stress in this beam by formula, we'll need the centroid of the cross-section, Y-bar, and then the so-called moment of inertia, I, about the centroidal axis which goes through Y-bar. To find y-bar and I, students are usually asked to use all these formulas and go through all these calculations. And we'll find that the centroid is located at a height of 38 millimeters from the bottom of this cross-section, at the middle, of course. Also, calculations give the moment of inertia, I, as the value in millimeters to the fourth power. These calculations can easily take 5 to 10 minutes. Alternatively, we can do all that easily using AutoCAD in less than a minute, after you've become familiar with the techniques taught here. First, we will draw this T-shape using two rectangles, which will be joined precisely using midpoint to midpoint object snap. Let's go to the rectangle command and specify any random starting point. Then, to specify the next corner, we type in the @ sign, followed by 90, which is the x displacement, and comma, negative 20, to go down by 20 units along y. Now let's draw the other rectangle, which is 30 by 40. Press rectangle again, click any starting point, and specify the other corner at 30, negative 40 units away. Next, we need to join them by attaching this midpoint to this midpoint. So, right-click here for your object snap options. Make sure the midpoint option is on and the object snap is on, and turn off any other toggles. Now let's click the move command to move this object. Press enter. Then grab it by its midpoint here and move it to the other rectangle's midpoint right here. Now we need to remove the two overlapping lines here in order to have a cross section like this. And we can use the trim command to do so. In trim, first pick all the objects to serve as cutting edges. You can simply pick everything. Press enter, then click on this line here twice to remove them, and press escape to exit. Now, to allow measurements of the centroid and I, we must process the drawing objects into a single entity called a region. Notice that they're currently just some separate lines. To do this, go to Draw and Region and pick everything forming the object and press Enter. A region is now created as one object. Now, before we measure the centroidal coordinates, please realize that AutoCAD will report those as a pair of x and y values. However, we have drawn this thing with a random starting point. Those coordinates will appear random. For example, the x value may be some random number rather than zero. So let's move it so that the midpoint of this line right here will sit exactly at the origin. To do that, we can press the move button here, or we can type M, then click the object we want to move, and then press Enter. Next, we grab its midpoint at the base, and we want to relocate that point to the origin at exactly 0, 0. Be careful how you do that. We need to first type in the number sign, hashtag, to tell AutoCAD that we want to enter absolute coordinates. After that, we can type in 0, 0. Okay, now it has moved far away, so let's do a zoom extents. To see where it is, you might need to zoom out a little more. It's right here, and that's all we need to work with. We won't need that for reference anymore, so let's just type in Z to zoom, and provide a window around the object. And we'll pan the drawing over a little bit. Now we're ready to measure the centroid and moment of inertia with MASSPROP command. This command is not available from the ribbon, so we type in MASSPROP. Just pick the region that we have created and press Enter. Then all our answers will appear here in the command window. In particular, the centroid has a Y value of 38. That's a coordinate value, which means that it's at 38 millimeters above the origin here. The other answer we need is right here, the so-called principal moment, or the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis, which is 868 times 10 to the third power in millimeters to the fourth power, which is the same as the number we found by calculations. Note that if the answers disappear, we can press F2 to see them again. Then we can copy and paste the results elsewhere as needed. I hope this video will save you some time as a student or as an engineer.